Hey there, Ian Vargo here from the Pro Audio Files and MasteringInTheBox.com. FabFilter just released the Pro Q3, which is an update to their flagship equalizer plugin. The Pro Q2 is something that I use on each and every mix of mine. It's great for cleaning up problem frequencies, it has a mostly transparent sound, tons of great features, and a beautiful user interface that provides you a lot of useful information. The Pro Q3 has all of that and even more, including an extremely useful dynamic EQ function. And now, per band, you can choose if you want to apply processing in mid-side mode, which essentially allows you to process the center, separate from the sides. You could work in traditional stereo, left or right. So what was already a great plugin is even more flexible. Because of this, I've found the Pro Q3 to be an excellent tool for when mastering, so today I'm going to show you how I would use the Pro Q3 when mastering a track. The song that I'm going to be using was just released. It's called Shirt from the band Plake, featuring Hunter Plake, who is on NBC's The Voice. Obviously, he's got an incredible voice, beautiful tone, great singer. So let's start by listening to about 45 seconds to a minute of this track. The song is really well produced, but there are some problem frequencies and areas where I think that I could enhance what was there. So let's have a listen.
I don't know how to prove that I can do better. 'Cause lately all I do is change with the weather. So babe, I understand I'm not your better man. I'll keep finding ways to break your heart. So get out while you can and find a better man that knows how not to break and fall apart.
All right, awesome track. So I have a couple of thoughts. I think that there's a little bit too much low end in the vocals in just the verses. Once the chorus comes in, I think it's fine. I also think that the kick drum is a little bit muddy, and that once the chorus kicks in, there's a little bit too much buildup in the 1 to 4 or 5K range, in particular because of the guitars. So I'm going to use this new feature in Pro Q3 that will help me identify unwanted peaks in the frequency spectrum. So Pro Q3 did tell me that there were some peaks, including at 2K and 2.8K. This is great information to have moving forward. So what I'd like to do now is go through my process and show you how I would use Pro Q3, and let's discuss the details afterwards.
I don't know how to prove that I can do better. 'Cause lately all I do. Better man that knows how not to break and fall.
myself to get out of bed cause I'm freaking out.
So now let me show you what I did and describe why. Firstly, I applied a high-pass filter, but only to the sides, because I thought there was some unwanted mud that wasn't adding anything to the program material just in the sides. I didn't want to affect the center. Next, I enlisted the dynamic EQ only in the sides at about 60. I did this because I wanted the kick drum, which is straight up the middle, to dominate that area of the frequency spectrum. Next, I found there to be an unwanted resonance at about 120, so just stereo traditional EQ notched that out a little bit. Next, I used the dynamic EQ again, but only in the sides, and that was for the purpose of carving out a little bit of 2 and 2.8K in those wide-panned guitars. Here, I used the dynamic EQ again, but it's only processing the middle, where the vocals live, to get rid of some unwanted harsh vocal sibilance. And lastly, I wanted to open up the sides a little bit using a traditional EQ to really allow us to hear those hi-hats a little clearer, and there were some cool vocal effects that I think were being buried that I wanted to enhance. So I'm doing a high shelf up there. So as you can see and hear, I'm doing mostly subtractive EQ here. I find that the FabFilter Pro Q2 and now the Pro Q3 are unmatched in that utility. If I have unwanted harshness, sibilance, boxiness, muddiness, whatever, I can find those frequencies really easy with the visual feedback the plugin provides me and remove them. If I want to add vibe, character, or tone to something, I might reach for an analog emulator, but for this utility, I love the Pro Q2 and now the Pro Q3. So well done, FabFilter, on another great update to this equalizer. It is an extremely useful tool, and I can see myself using it for individual tracks, buses, and now mastering.